Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, and especially in this video. So guys, as you can see on the screen, in this video I'm just going to talk about how to configure federation service, which is also known as Active Directory Federation Service or ADFS. Very important. So guys, in this video I will be taking you through five things we will be discussing, and I hope this video will be informative. So as you can see here, I will give you a small introduction about federation service and what is identity federation, because it's not an easy kind of work. It's a little bit tactic and you need lots of good idea about all those things, what and all we have in this. So I hope this video will be informative, and very first, I will introduce you, then we will understand what is identity and federation. Identity federation basically, and what is ADFS 2.0 and components, and what are the prerequisites of this. So guys, first of all, let me talk about what is Active Directory Federation service. So it is one of the service, okay, of Active Directory basically, and key aspect of configuring Active Directory configuring identity and access, which is also known as IDA solutions with Windows Server, either 2008, 2012 or 2016 Active Directory. So basically it is all about authentication and authorization concept. Basically, to configure Active Directory Federation service, you need to be familiar with concepts of Active Directory Federation service and its various deployment scenario. And in addition, if I tell you, you should know how to deploy Active Directory Federation service in your organization and implement Active Directory Federation service claims. And I have already uploaded one big video in that I had discussed about how you can do it for single organization. In this video or in my coming up videos, I'll be talking about how we can implement this between two organizations, because it is used basically for making secure communication between two organizations only. Okay, but if required, you can do it for single organization also. So Active Directory Federation is made up of several identity federation components that enable businesses to establish trust and share resources across predefined boundaries basically. And understanding ADFS 2.0 components and how they interact plays a direct role in successful deployment. So this is what I was talking about. So this is very a small introduction. Basically, it is used for providing high security, high level security, which is also known as identity and access. And in very simple word, you can have single user ID and you can access multiple application with the same user ID from any organization. But for that, you need to implement Active Directory Federation service. This is the concept, simple concept, which is also known as single sign-on. Okay, now here, what is identity federation here? So guys, identity federation is a process that enables the distribution of identification, authorization and authentication across organization and platform boundaries. And you can implement identity federation between two organizations that have a relationship of trust between them. Okay, as part of the trust, the organization defines which resource can be accessed and the method to access the resource. And you can use ADFS 2.0 to implement identity federation on Windows Server 2008, 2012, 2016 and even on 2019. Okay, and ADFS 2.0 is an identity solution that provides streamlined browser-based access to one or more application or services. This is possible even when the user account and application are located across a variety of network or organization. And it uses, it relies on port 80 or 443, which is secure and default 80 for communication from the internet. And this is considered a key advantage over the traditional Active Directory Federation, domain service, Active Directory domain service trust. And ADDS trust relies on a large number of open port, including RPC, Kerberos and LDAP. Now the second thing you should see here, the next thing, what is ADFS 2.0. So guys, it is a version, okay, nothing special in this. Active Directory Federation Service 2.0 is a technology that simplifies access to resources through the use of claim-based model. So what is claim and all, I have already spoken about in my previous videos. In this video, I'm not covering those things. In my coming up videos, I will be talking about in detail, because when I will be configuring, it will be easy to understand. In this, I will be talking about prerequisites things we will prepare. I will prepare one scenario where we will deploy all those things. And if you go through a little bit more here, enterprise claim provider for claim based application. If you have claim based application, you can configure this. And federation service for identity federation across domains. So I'm not going in deep in this theoretical part. But let me go through. And ADFS server can be configured as a claims provider and issue claims about authenticated users. This allows an organization to provide its users with access to claims aware application in another organization by using single sign-on, which is I was talking about earlier, which is also known as SSO. And this service offer a federated web SSO across domains, which is discussed. I will be discussing about all those things. This enhances security and reduces overhead for IT administrators. Now, the benefits of deploying Active Directory Federation Service 2.0 includes secure collaboration across different domain and organization, reduce the need for duplicate account and other credentials management overhead, provide for identity delegation. You can, Active Directory Federation Service 2.0 support identity delegation, which allows IT administrator to specify certain accounts called delegates to impersonate users, and enables step up authentication. Now, these are the basic component of Active Directory Federation 2.0. So as you can see here, we have one domain controller, and this is called partner account. If you have partner account, second organization you can consider. This is account federation server and federation trust. This is what we are creating. Federation service proxy, resource federation server, a web server running Active Directory Federation service along with web service and agent. This is the resource partner. So in detail, I will talk about all those things in my coming up videos. Now here, before making a successful configuration, you need to take care of a couple of things, which is known as Active Directory Federation 2.0 prerequisites. So the very first thing here, network connectivity, okay, and client computer, domain controller, federation service server, federation service proxy when applicable only, Active Directory Federation 2.0 web agent, and apart from this, Active Directory domain service, DNS. DNS is very important for name resolutions, because if you have two organization, A organization, B organization, A organization is running on 192 network 192.168 and B organization is running on 172 network kind of thing. So in that condition, DNS is mandatory. Without DNS, name resolution will not happen. I will show you here. In my previous video, I uploaded how to configure trust, Active Directory domains in trust. In that, I had spoken about how we can enable, static root on Windows Server 2019, and how we can enable a conditional forward and all. The same I'm using here. And certificate very important for communication. Okay, these are the very basic requirement. So guys, here this is my infra. I'm using two server here, and I have two domain. One is my india.com, second one is abcd.com, and these are the name of computer, and this is the IP address 172.22.144.254, and here 192. So at the end, what we will understand, we will create a communication federation service between both the company. Okay. Before that, as you can see here, it is having two separate IP address, separate network. So for that, we have to configure a conditional forward for name resolution. Then we need to configure static root, or if in organization, they will provide you, networking team will provide you all the networking kind of things, so that you can communicate with 172 and 192. But here it is a lab environment, so I have enabled static root, so I can communicate. Okay, I will show you here. And this is a request. If you feel this video is informative at the end, please don't forget to subscribe channel, comment, share and like this video. And let me begin with this. very first thing. I will show you. This is my, I have one machine where I have deployed my both the server, Active Directory and, I mean both Active Directory. So this is india.com. I'm going to log in here. So guys, here in this video I will not cover entire configuration because it's not a small configuration. It takes 3 or 4 hours to make each and everything. So here I will be giving you only the basic requirement. The very first requirement is Active Directory certificate service we need to configure. So I will configure for both the organization. Okay, and in my next video, the next step I will be talking about. So as you can see here, basic information I will give you what I have already done. This is my Active Directory domain server. Okay, india.com as you can see here, and IP address 192.168.0.254. And here DNS, I have created one conditional forward here. This is my india.com. I created conditional forward abcd.com, next organization. And same here, if you go to this local server and check here, abcd.com, and it is having 172 network. Okay, and apart from this, I have enabled india.com as a conditional forward. And most important here guys, I have enabled routing. I will show you that also here. This static route I have configured here like this, so that I'm able to communicate with my 192 network. So let me show you here. This is my, I'm pinging from this 172 network. Okay, this, that is my abcd.com 192. So so as you can see here, I'm able to ping my 192 network. Okay, and if you give I'm just verifying you, it is pinging. And here also you can check. So these are the basic things you need to take care. Here you can ping 172. This is 172. As you can see here, it is getting pinged. Okay, now guys, very first thing you have to install certificate service, and you have to configure that. Then you will have you will go for next one. So I'm going for Active Directory certificate only. Okay, on both the server. Here select Active Directory authority or certificate authority and web enrollment mandatory. Two option on both the server. Just skip install, and I'm going to my second server also. Same here, give Active Directory certificate service and federation we will install later on. These are the prerequisites you need to configure, then only that will be successful, that the configuration. So I'm not selecting anything except certificate authority and web enrollment. Next and give install. Okay, so we need to wait till the time it plays. Very, you know, you can say it's a backbone for this configuration, Active Directory certificate authority. So let me see if it is done here. Almost done. It is very, you know, a little bit, it requires a little bit extra concentration. If you make a small mistake, it is quite difficult to identify where we made a mistake. It is just few seconds away from this completion, so it is done. Now configure Active Directory certificate service on this destination server, on this destination server or this server. So you can click here, just give next here. Okay, again it will ask what you want to install here, like select role services. So I'm going with certificate authority and web enrollment. I require two only. You have to select enterprise certificate authority and here root certificate authority. Okay, and create new key, and this also leave default length. And this is a you know, if you want to give any name you can give. So I will change your name. I'm just adding here at the end 2019 because I'm using 2019 server. Okay, and just give next here and give next here also and just click configure. Okay, same thing you have to do this side also on this server. Click next, select both option. Enterprise, root, create new key, length same, and this one also I will give 2019. Click next. 5 years validity for this and configure. Once this is done, we will have the rest of configuration. So it is done. Close this and close this also. Now so guys, it is done. Now we have to, you know, turn off distribution point and authority information access. First of all, this is the very first step we have to follow here. So for that, you need to go to Active Directory Certificate Authority. Certificate Authority is here. And just go to property of this, property and extensions. This option you will get. So you have to remove this file and that LDAP option. Okay. Yes, and this LDAP. So this is CDP. I have removed. And now I need to click this HTTP and select this option. Okay, include. Not this, second option, include in the CDP extension of issued certificate. Okay, and just click apply. Yes. Similarly, you have to go to identity information, delete this file, this LDAP, and click this HTTPS. And check mark this and apply. You have to do this on second server also. I'm doing at the same time, guys. Same. I mean, I don't want. I'm not leaving any configuration on any server. So just click on this. Go to tools now and certificate authority. Just right click, property. Okay, extensions, very important this. Files you have to remove, LDAP you have to remove. Click HTTPS and issued certificate. Click OK, yes. And next, authority information access is delete this also. And delete LDAP. And click SDP and extension. So we have done the basic configuration and requirement on both server. Just click OK and now we will verify some automatically installed certificate. Okay, for that on both server you just need to go to MMC. So I'm doing this on my evhd.com. Click add and remove snap-in. Here you have to select certificate authority, certification authority, and yes, local computer, finish and give OK. And here you will see one certificate generated. Sorry, here you need to select certificate, not certificate authority. MMC, go to MMC. Certification authority, that is. So you have to select only certificates. Yes, computer account. Local, finish. And just keep OK here. And now if you go to personal folder, you will have one certificate there. And you can verify a couple of things from here. If you go to, you know, details, you should see this number. It is telling you 949C. Okay, serial number ending, I'm telling you. And it is giving lots of information like issuer and all, who issued, issued by, lots of information. So same you will see here for india.com. Okay, just close this, go to MMC and just click add and remove snap-in. Certificates. Oh, there you go. Computer account only, just next, finish, click OK. And you will see one certificate here, personal. So these are the, you know, self-generated certificate for those Active Directory, I mean certificate authority for that particular server. Okay, now next what we have to do here, now we have to configure one web server certificate template to allow domain controller and domain computer computers permission to access the certificate. Okay, for that what we have to do, again you have to go to MMC, just close this one, not required, and here also you can close. So on both server you have to go to MMC once again. Now you have to go to templates, certificate templates. So here you will get certificate template, add this and click OK. Okay, now go to template, you will see one web server template here. This is what I was talking about, this web server template. So go to property, I'm doing this on my abcd.com. Okay, you can see a couple of things like, you know, security, extensions, subject, request handling, and general. So the main work what we have to do is here you have to go to security, just click add here and go to advanced, and from here find now select domain. So domain computer you have to select, domain controller you have to select, and network service IIS users you have to select, network service you have to select, network service, network service, so I'm just clicking 3 only, and once again I will go and search network service. So you have to select 4 options from here, network service, this one, click OK, and you have to give, you know, enroll, right? So for network service enroll, and for this IIS users enroll, domain computers enroll, permission domain controllers enroll, apply, OK. So this is the this is the setting, one setting you have to do on both server. Okay, so I'm going my india.com now, MMC here, again I need to add certificate template. Okay, just click OK. Web server, you have to go to web server template, just go to property, click security here and add those 4 items, domain, computer, domain controller, and IIS user, and network service. Click OK. Again, you will have to assign permission. So network service enroll, this user enroll, IIS, domain controller, domain computers, apply, OK. So if you want, you can just verify. Okay, it's just verification, cross verification. Yes, you can close this now. Now you can, you know, you can just restart Active Directory service once on both the server after this. So go to services, even you can run command, but from here also you can do it. Active Directory domain service restart, yes. Active Directory domain service as well as Active Directory certificate service. Certificate service is more important to restart, not domain service here. So you can do it from services. Services, Active Directory services will be on the top. Active Directory certificate service, and just restart this. So we have done the next step. What we have to do, we have to create one web server certificate. For that, I'm doing first on my india.com. I'm going to IIS manager. First I will create one certificate. These are the certificates which will make secure communication. So So here I'm going certificate, server certificates, and we need to create domain certificate. This option you have to select. Here you can give, you know, name like better give your full computer name. Okay, this one. So click change. I will copy it full to avoid any mistake. And this is what required here. And organization you can give like India, whatever you want you can give. And you can give any department. I'm giving my locality. And and this is India. So you have to give this much information and just click next. And it is checking, I mean it will check who is the authority to provide the certificate. Okay, and friendly name you can give like what you want to give, you can give any name. So I'm giving just India. India FD. Or I will change this. I will give this much better. My computer name only I will give. Click next, finish only. Same thing you have to do. So you got two certificate here, okay, but both certificate will have separate serial number. So I'm going to my secondary server, I mean second abcd.com. Here IIS manager. Okay, now go to server. Here you will get server certificates, create a domain certificate. So as you can see here, one certificate is already there. Okay, you got it. Now common name, you can take help from here. I don't want to make any mistake, that is why I'm doing like this. Because I had made one mistake in my previous video. So organization, once again I'm giving it like ABCD, ABCD, and again IT department. And this is this is also same I'm giving. And this is also India. Give next here. And it will check who is certificate authority, and I will give this name once again. And click finish. So you will see two certificate here now. Okay, now we need to, you know, import this certificate, and then we will have to bind this certificate. So click sites. Binding is very important. Okay, this is default site. Go to bindings and click add here. On both server you have to do. I'm binding with 443. Okay, and select that certificate just now we created. So as you can see here, it is showing two certificate. Okay, but we have created that certificate only. We need to select here. So for that, what we need to do, we need to go to once again certificate server, because I don't want to select any other certificate. So I will check what is the serial number for this. So it is 002. I need this certificate only over there. Bindings 002 certificate only. Add. I can view here. Okay, go to details. So it should tell you it is 002. Okay, correct certificate. And even you can select IP address here and just give OK. Same thing you have to do on this server also. So I would like to check. Okay, 2019. I do not need to take this 2019. It is showing. Just go to sites and double click on this bindings. Add. I lost connection to my system. So we got it. Okay, select this IP address. What is this? Wait, just click add here. Okay, and HTTPS. So you will get more option, and I don't want this 2019. Okay, you can even select IP address here and just skip. If you want, you can view here. So detail it will give you for this verification. You can verify it is telling 220 here also, and to just give OK. And if you want, you can verify whether you have selected the proper certificate or not. 220 that was, or 002 it seems. So this was the certificate. Now just close this on both the server. Now we have to export both server and then import cross. So I hope you understand what I'm trying to say. I'm saying we have to install India certificate on ABCD, ABCD on India. For that, first we need to export, then we can import. So for that, you need to once again go to MMC here. You need to add certificates now. Certificates. So here you will see two certificates now, and you have to select computer account. Okay, local computer, and just click OK, and go to personal folder and certificates. So now you can see there are two certificates. Okay, so we need this certificate. We have created this on web server. Okay, this one. So just click all tasks and export it. Give next. It should be, you should select do not export the private key. Okay. And here you should select .cerder encoded binary x.509.cer certificate format. And just browse it. And I'm giving desktop location. And I'm giving just name India FD. Okay, India, and this is Federation Service FD. I gave name and saving it. So you should take care of this also, and just click next. Successfully exported. Now, oh sorry, I did it on abcd.com. Okay, I will rename that. Let me save abcd.com only. it is abcd.com. okay, abcd.com, abcdfd, same I have to do here. MMC, go to certificates. Personal certificates, this one we required. Okay, this is also done. So we have done the basic thing here. Okay, just close no, say no. And here also you can close this. Now we have exported, now we have to import cross. So this is my 192.168.0.254. And I need that India.com certificate here, not this one. Not this one, okay. Desktop, I need this certificate. So before that, I should delete this from just keeping on desktop only. And similarly, I need that certificate, I mean that ABCD here. So I can access here on remote. 172.22.144.254. Users, administrator, and this, sorry, I need desktop. And this ABCD. So I copied India to ABCD, ABCD to India. Okay, now we have to import this. So you can use group policy so that it will be deployed to all group policy management you can use. So I'm doing this on my India.com, and you can do it on your, you know, default domain policy. Default domain policy, this one you should select here. And just go to computer, edit, computer configuration, policies, Windows setting, here, Windows setting, no script, you have to go to security settings, and here you will get public key policy, then trusted root certificate, and just right click and import that certificate. So this is my India.com, India organization. I have to install abcd.com here. Import. So this is my abcd.com. okay, and click next and finish. Same you have to do here on this server. You have to add that India certificate on abcd, then go to tools, group policy management. Default, edit, group policy, policy, software, Windows setting, security setting, then public key policy, tested root certification, import that. So guys, in this video I will be sharing this much information only. Okay, so you have to, here you have to select India. This is called prerequisites, very important configuration for this. Okay, in next video I'll be talking about the next step, how we can configure claims. Okay, I hope till now you have understood all the steps and all the requirement, all the configuration, and so it is also imported successfully. Now if you close this and go to once again MMC, you will see this certificate also. Certificates. So we'll verify once where it is gone. So it will be here, it seems. Trusted root. Okay. And as you can see here, it should show India.com. So as of now it is showing 2 only, so that should be trusted. Enterprise, it will be somewhere, it will come here only. Trusted publisher, I will have to search trusted people. Just refresh it. And let me go to India. Oh, we need to run command also. CMD. GP update / force. Okay, that deployment should happen here also. CMD GP update / force. So as you can see here, India.com came on my ABCD, and if I go to ABCD, I should be able to see India.com certificate here. So once again MMC, I need to go to MMC and click certificates. And go to trusted root certificate, and here this is India.com. ABCD should be coming. So as you can see here, ABCD also came, and India is already there. So guys, the very first step we have done this successfully, and next video I'll be talking about the next part of this configuration, which is like, you know, we have done couple of things in this video. Basic things understood, and certificate authority. Then we will install Active Directory Federation service in next video. Then the rest of options, like how we can create, you know, claims and all the rest of thing. There will be lots of things to understand, to learn in this video. So till then, bye bye, have a nice time. Thanks for watching for this video, and wait for my next video.